This is Will Starks. You're now listening to Line for Line Podcast.
I'm in love with the grind. I'm in love with the culture.
Yeah.
Do this for the fam. Do this for Kenosha.
You know I got your Kenosha.
If you got the vision,
then
come a little closer. Let's get it together. Life aligned with the soldiers. I'm in love with the grind. I'm in love with the culture. Do this for the fam. Do this for Kenosha.
Yeah.
If you got the vision,
then
come a little closer.
Let's go.
Let's get it together.
Let's get
Life aligned with the soul.
All right. Just like that, we're back in another episode of Line for Line. I got a very special guest in the building. I'll go ahead and let him introduce himself to the world.
Will Starks. I'm class of 2023. I go to Kenosha Tremper.
Will the Thrill, huh? Yeah, put some respect on your name, huh? Had a real good game yesterday, too. Before we get into that, just tell people a little bit about you, sir.
I've been playing basketball for around 12 years. Mm-hmm. I've been playing AAU for probably like 6-7.
Yeah.
So I started that. I really went out to Chicago, tried to get a little better at basketball. It wasn't always my thing. I tried to force it. Yeah. I really wasn't always that good. You know, people used to clown me trying to play. I was just the big kid on the team.
Yeah.
But, you know, eventually down the road, we got a little better at it, probably like 7th, 8th grade.
Mm-hmm.
And from there, I've just been playing ever since.
What were some things that you were telling yourself when you did have people clowning you, thinking you weren't that good or maybe wouldn't be good at all?
Just stay consistent with it. You mm-hmm. know, it's a lot of players who, even in the NBA, college, anywhere, they ain't start off the best.
Yeah.
You know, nothing in life going to be easy, but I just kept with it.
What were some things that you did to make sure you worked on your game and stayed consistent at that point?
So when we first got here, I probably moved here to Kenosha in 5th grade.
Mm-hmm.
I started off in like the Boys and Girls Club.
Nice.
Going to little leagues or whatever.
The old Boys and Girls Club.
And I wasn't doing too good with that.
Oh, no.
So I started going to the Y and got a membership.
Mm-hmm.
I probably stay in there in the summertime from probably like 10 in the morning
mm-hmm.
to closing time. 9
Stop
p.m.
playing.
I promise you.
Wow.
Every day. Staying in
the
gym.
That's dedication.
Yes, sir.
And obviously being at the YMCA, you get to come mm-hmm. across older people as well,
yes,
too.
Sir.
Tell us a little bit about what that was like.
It's good playing with the older cats. You know, everybody hate to play with old heads. They always talking to you and stuff like that. But I feel like I just took the advice that they gave me and
yeah.
I tried to implement it in my game and stuff like that. So I feel like it was definitely rougher competition. And
mm-hmm.
I feel like that's where I get a lot of my grit from.
Yeah.
You know, just going on the court, being physical. It's easier to do it with kids in your grade, especially playing older cats.
Yeah.
So now it's just transferring over to that.
And I noticed you say you got here in 5th grade. Where'd you move from?
I moved from Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Milwaukee. So you're a big-time Bucks fan?
I really didn't like the Bucks that much. They just never was that.
So it's the Bulls,
that team. Not even the Bulls.
On,
not even the Bulls. Anywhere
Come
LeBron
on.
Was at, I was at.
Okay.
I'm a big LeBron fan.
Okay,
I'm a big
you.
LeBron fan.
So you a Lakers fan right now, then?
Yes, sir.
And they flopping, boy. I'll tell you. What's
we going to bounce back. We going to bounce back.
And do what?
We going to the chip.
Man, my dude. Okay. So we talked a little bit about sports. Are you a multiple sport athlete or is it only basketball? What's up?
Used to be a multiple sport athlete. I did baseball and basketball.
Mm-hmm.
I quit baseball around 8th grade, 7th grade. It was just too much with the schedules.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, trying to do both, you got to be good. Really trying to perfect your craft at one.
Mm-hmm.
So I really just like basketball a little bit more, the crowd and stuff like that. And a lot of the friends just really stopped playing baseball. So I stopped playing baseball.
My dude. So just tell us a little bit about how the season's going for you. As someone who gets to do the videography for Tremper, I get to see you out there oftentimes.
Right.
Tell us a little bit about the season.
We started off, you know, what was we, 4-2, something
mm-hmm.
like that. We was doing good. We started off real good. I just felt like, you know, every season, at least that I done played for 3 years I've been in high school, we done had a rough patch.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like every team go through the rough patch. We went on like a 4-game losing streak, 5-game losing streak, and yesterday we caught a dub. So I feel like this is where we turned it back around. You know, everybody going to talk and say that we the underdogs or we just not that good, but I feel like every team got L's, and you look at the conference, no team is just undefeated,
mm-hmm.
you know. So I feel like them L's right there, we just got to disregard those and keep it pushing with the W's.
Yes, sir. Now just tell us a little bit about what's going through your mind and how do you coach your teammates up when you're going through a rough patch where you're losing a couple in a row?
Just telling them from experience, because we got a lot of new guys on the team
mm-hmm.
and a lot of players who like this their first year or varsity or second year. Just being there with that freshman year team, we went pretty far.
Yeah.
You know, we was playing teams like Case. They beat us in the regular season. In the playoffs, we still felt like we was going to beat them. So I'm just telling them, you know, stay consistent and know that even though we lose to a team, we can bounce back and beat them in the same breath. So, you know, just telling them that I done been here before.
Mm-hmm.
We done been here before, whether it's JV, freshman. You done lost games, you done won games. So it's basketball at the end of the day. No pressure. Just go back out there and try to get a dub.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Now, what type of player would you describe yourself as when you're out there on the court?
Definitely one of the most physical players.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if I ain't got the best talent, I'm going to make sure I got the best heart out there.
Yeah.
So that's one thing since I've been younger. You know, the talent obviously done came around, but
uh-huh.
I ain't always had the talent. I always had the heart, though. So, you know, I'm going to try to outwork everybody on the court game.
Yes, sir. You know? So just tell us a little bit about the game yesterday where you guys were able to come out with the dub. You came up clutch when it comes to taking that charge.
Yes, sir.
You did a good thing, and that was at the right time as well, too. So just tell us a little bit about what all went into that dub.
Really, you know, we started off that game. I feel like they came out, hit a few threes. They pretty much showed us something that we didn't expect, I say. We kind of probably underestimated them a little bit. And I feel like for the season, we've been doing that a little bit where we kind of come out and we kind of showing out in that second half and going too far behind. So just gathering up the team and letting them know in that first half, we got to go ahead and take charge. And I feel like we kept the game close the whole game at that. The end of that game, that charge is really position defense, you know.
Yeah.
Coach Morris always preaching in practice, so it was my first time getting the slide over and take the charge, so I know he was excited about it.
Yeah.
But it was really just being there and not trying to go up and try to block it. I just knew it was going to probably be a foul. You swatting that something, I had like around three fouls, four fouls,
yeah.
So I knew I had to get there,
yes, sir.
And luckily it went in our favor.
Yeah, so I couldn't make it to that game, obviously, mm-hmm. but what was it like in the locker room? Just what was the atmosphere like after finally breaking through and getting the W?
Oh, man, we ran back there. We had the Gatorade, the little Gatorade bottles with the water. We throwing them up like we just want a chip.
You know,
it feel good to catch a W for sure. So
yeah.
I just think we was more excited, not just for that one win, but just knowing that we capable of keeping up with any team in the conference, out of the conference, any team in general.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like after catching that dub, that's going to steer us in the right direction.
Yes, sir. Now, if there was one thing that you could say, well, this is a two-part question.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if there's one thing that you could say the team could do better and you could do better,
mm-hmm.
what would that thing be?
I would say for me personally, free throws. Mm-hmm. I feel like it's been more of a mental thing for me, not even just a talent thing or just like you're not practicing enough. We practice a lot. I shoot a lot of free throws. I make a lot of free throws. When we get into the game, it's kind of like a little rough patch sometimes. So I feel like just being consistent with that, not shying away from it, and just trying to get better at that each game, each practice, I feel like that's something I need to work on. As far as a team, it's the chemistry, I think, because I feel like we got the most skilled team. I definitely feel like we got the most skilled team in Kenosha, possibly in the state. I don't care about no other team besides the team that I'm playing with.
You about to get me in trouble, man.
Go ahead. I definitely feel like we got one of the most skilled teams. We got everything we need. It's just about the chemistry that we got.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we've been missing a lot of players every week. We got players out with thumb fractures, wrist fractures. So, you know, once we get that team all together and everybody bonded and, you know, communicating, moving as a unit, I feel like we'll be good.
Yeah, my dude, Sir. Now, just tell us a little bit about the coaching staff, because obviously I'm someone who's at all the games, mm-hmm. and I just see how involved your coaching staff is, whether it's an assistant, whether it's the JV coaches or anything like that. Just tell us how honored and blessed that you guys are to have a coaching staff that you do have.
Starting off with Coach Morris, you know, he always on us every day. Mm-hmm. Every day he's going to be on us. It ain't a practice that he come in that he's not going to be on us. So he really just try to, you know, prepare us for life outside of basketball, too, through basketball.
Yeah.
So I appreciate him for that. The assistant coaches, Coach Young, Coach Young, Coach Brown, Coach Curtis, they all work every day to try to make us better as human beings and basketball players. So I appreciate them for that. When we in practices and, you know, we just came off of L, it's hard to come back and practice and really try to go hard. Everybody down.
Yeah.
They make sure we lift right back up and, you know, forget about the L. Let's go ahead and work towards the next W. So I appreciate them for that.
Yes, sir. Now, a lot of people at home who may not know, just tell us a little bit about the difference of speed when it comes to practice and then in the actual game.
Yeah, with practices, you know, some days you got cats who want to come in, cats being myself or anybody, come in and, you know, we kind of jogging it, you know, halfway doing it, and the game is nonstop. So we try our hardest in practice just to, you know, keep up with speed that it would kind of be game-like.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and the game is nonstop. They trying to win, we trying to win. So you got to just adapt to going in there and playing at full speed 100% in practice and outside of practice.
Yes, sir. Now, we noticed that you guys do have a whole week off of basketball.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What are some things that you will be working on yourself personally
mm-hmm.
to get ready for that next game, which will be next Saturday, I believe?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Definitely probably end of practices, 250 free throws made.
Mm,
we got to do that every day up into that game. So, you know, just doing stuff like that. Finishing maybe, you know, just shooting the ball a little bit more, rebuilding the confidence in the shot. So stuff like that, I think that's what we need to get down packed before we get to Saturday.
Yes, sir. Now, the NBA, is that something that you dream of?
I feel like every kid dream of that. Yeah,
yeah,
I definitely dream of it for sure. You know,
what are some things that goes into making sure you accomplish that?
Just staying consistent, really. Mm-hmm. It's always about consistency. Any player that you see that done made it there, they really on a nonstop schedule. You know, basketball is in it every day.
Mm-hmm.
So just try not to slip up and miss a day and try to be too content with where I'm at. You know, you can be one of the top players now and be forgot about down the road. Just want to make sure I'm one of those players. So I'm going to try my hardest to get there, you know, you shoot for the moon, you miss, you know, you're still up there.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Now, is there anyone out there that you want to shout out that helped you get to where you are at right now as a person and as a player?
It's a lot of people. I'm going to miss the people. I know I am. definitely my mom. My mom, you know, she always with me through the thick and thin, you know. She actually gave me a motivational speech before the game yesterday, nice. You know, just about the free throws, because I felt like I was shying away from it, mm-hmm. not trying to get the ball now because I'm missing so many of them. And I feel like that's what really helped me yesterday, especially because I kind of, even when I missed one, I'm still trying to go get the ball and I'm trying to dominate still. Yeah. So, you know, I like thank my mom, my dad. He always at every game, and, you know, he coaching me up through it. My coaches, especially any coach, like any coach throughout the process of just me being a basketball player, they always help me out. And then a Tremper student section, you know, hey. Gotta shout out Tremper.
They be going lit for y'all, man. Yes, I swear. Sir. When I went to that first game when y'all played the ITA, the way they were screaming when I heard your name on there, I'm like, yes, man, sir. let me make sure he legit first before I like get behind him and say, sir. Man, they was screaming, it was going crazy. Yes, and then he got out there and laid an egg. But no, you definitely did your thing that game as well, sir. Too.
Appreciate you.
But as we get ready to close out, definitely got to pop some stuff with this question right here. Mm. But who would you say has been the toughest player that you've played all season and that you look forward to playing the most again?
Toughest player all season. That's tough. Whew. I say Amari from Case.
For real?
I want to see him again.
That's the guy with the dreads, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
He probably didn't have the best game against us when we played him, mm-hmm. but I know that, you know, he feeling himself off the win, so you know we see him again February 4th, I think.
Hey, you got it written down.
I'm looking forward to it. That's along with Bradford, ITA, all the team. Yeah. You know, I ain't just closed in on just one player, but I'm looking forward to all those teams.
You said they're gonna have to see you, huh? They're gonna have to see you,
by ITA especially.
My dude. With that being said, young man, we just wrapped up an amazing episode of Line for Line. We appreciate you for sliding through.
Appreciate
sir.
You. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
I can see it all. Bill was in the plex, pool with the mansion, accountant full of wrecks, podcast preaching. Reaching for the stars, coops all foreign air, week of home massage. I can't speak for y'all, this was a dream I've been discovered. Last people try to stop it, I don't think that they recovered. Know my haters mad, they never seen it done with ease. Chase the dream and not the cheese, that's when you hustling with means. Ay.